Hi, I'm Dave Dickens. This is the monthly economic and market update for October 2017. Today's Tuesday, October 3. Before I get started with the market and economic update, I just want to make mention of the horrible devastation that's going on in Puerto Rico and also the really tragic events from Las Vegas this past weekend. It's possible that somebody watching this video has friends or family that were involved in either of those events. And I just want to say that we are thinking about those people and praying for those people and hoping that something really good comes out of that for the people that were involved in those really, really devastating events. Today I want to cover a little bit of recent economic news that frankly just broke this morning, a little bit about the tax cut that was announced over the weekend, at least the plans for a tax cut, and then a little indication of what I think that might mean for the stock market over the next 3 to 4 months, and then a couple of housekeeping items to finish up. So first, there was a really good piece of economic news that just came out this morning. It was automobile sales for September. They were up significantly, way above expectations. And the thing that really charged that was a whole lot of automobile sales out of Texas, directly related to Hurricane Harvey. So if you watched this update last month, you might remember that I said one of the things that we're likely to see out of the hurricanes from Texas, Louisiana, and Florida is actually some economic activity moving up. So automobile sales, we already see that. I think the next thing we're going to see is increased activity from rebuilding, which is going to help building suppliers and the people that are actually doing that construction. So while insurance companies have been hurt, the economy might actually get a boost from the effects of those two hurricanes. So stay tuned for more positive economic news on that front. The tax cut that was just announced last week, frankly, it'll be a bit of a miracle if that actually gets done sometime in 2017. Two different pieces to it. The biggest piece, and maybe the easiest to pass, is a tax cut for corporations. The expectation is that the corporate tax rate is going to drop from 35%, maybe as low as 20%. And if that happens, that will bring additional earnings for the companies that we invest in the stock market. So that would be a real positive. There are also some changes that were recommended for individuals. And those are a lot more complicated, and it's really difficult to determine what that'll mean for you and for me going forward. But they're proposing that 7 current brackets get reduced to just 3. So there would only be a 12% bracket, a 25% tax bracket, and a 33% tax bracket, with the possibility of a fourth tax bracket during all the negotiations that are going to have to go on. There are a ton of details that have to come out on this. But a couple things we know for sure that are in the proposed plan. The standard deduction for people who do not itemize on their tax returns is proposed to double. And that would actually be a really good thing for most Americans, because most Americans don't itemize on their taxes. But the personal exemption we get is expected to go to 0. That's not a huge thing if you're a 1 or 2 person household, but if you've got 3 or 4 kids at home and you're getting a personal exemption for each of those, that will actually cause your taxes to go up. A lot of the debate, discussion, fighting that we're gonna hear over the next 2, 3, 4 months on this has to do with whether or not this proposal is gonna be revenue neutral or whether it's gonna depend on economic growth to make sure that we don't run ever-increasing deficits and add to the national debt. Everybody watching this video knows that we now have over a $20 trillion national debt. And there are a lot of senators and congresspeople who are gonna say, you know what, I'm not interested in a tax cut that's actually gonna make this problem continue to get bigger. So there's a lot of water that's gonna have to pass under this bridge before tax cuts are actually going to come into place. A lot more to come on that. What does all that mean for the stock market? I don't think that the stock market is dramatically depending on this tax cut bill for its growth that we've had over this year. October tends to be not that great of a seasonal month, but November, December are always seasonally strong. So there's a really good probability that we have a continued run in the stock market through year end. Interest rates seem to be stuck at really low levels, and it's kind of hard to see what's going to make them go up anytime soon. And what really caught my eye is that projections for earnings, but more importantly for me, projections for corporate revenues are actually moving higher. Corporations can monkey around with their earnings, and do, but it's really hard to monkey around with your revenues. And so if revenues are rising with rising profits, I think that's going to be a continued tailwind for stocks over the next couple of quarters at least. And then we got the economic benefit coming out of these hurricanes that we mentioned early on in this video. So I think, generally speaking, the next couple of quarters could be pretty positive for the stock market. One thing I want to mention is there are only four times in the last 100 years that we've gone longer than this without a 5% or more market correction. So we are way overdue for at least a 5 to 7 to 10% pullback. When that happens, not if that happens, but when that happens, I don't think that throws us off the track for a continued rising stock market. But we are way overdue for one of those 5 to 7% corrections, so expect it. Finally, I just want to alert you to a couple of things that we've been doing here recently. Lunch and Learns, Wind Down Mondays, and Coffee Connections. They've been really popular with the clients who have been attending them. It's just strictly education and really good education. If you go to our website, coveryourassetskc.com, you'll see a list of what we have going on for October. But they include a topic called, Do I Need a Trust? And another one, which is Social Security questions, lots of them. So if you want to sign up for one of those, they're totally free. It's all education. All you got to do is call and ask either Elizabeth or Melody to put you on that list, and we'd love to have you come for those. You're also welcome to bring a friend or two. Again, it's strictly education. So if you have a friend you'd like to bring with you, we'd love that as well. Finally, last month I mentioned the Equifax problems they had with the data being stolen, possibly your personal data. If you have not yet gone out to EquifaxSecurity2017.com, I want to again stress that you do that. I have done that, found out that my personal information was included in the amount that, in the information that was stolen, which you find out really quickly once you answer a few questions on that site. And then it's up to you whether you want to sign up for their free credit monitoring for a year. This information that was stolen were Social Security numbers and driver's licenses. Those things don't change over your lifetime. You can cancel a credit card, you can't cancel your Social Security number. So I'd again encourage you, EquifaxSecurity2017.com. So that's the October monthly economic and market update. I hope something in here has been valuable for you. We'll look forward to seeing you hopefully in the office, but certainly on next month's video. Have a great month.